Have you been thinking to make an upgrade to your DIY solar system to allow for more power to charge your batteries, but you don't really know where to begin? Well, today we're going to be doing a review and we're going to be having a look at a 60 amp MPPT charge controller from LiTime. I've had this MPPT charge controller for about 2 to 3 weeks now. In this full review, you can expect to see me test out and demonstrate the maximum power that I got out of my 800 watt solar panel array. I'll also demonstrate a really cool trick if any of you are interested on how to increase the power output of your solar panel array by 24% just using water. Now, this is a collection of secondhand panels that I've stringed together in series, not in parallel. Long story short, running them in series is highly efficient for the MPPT charge controller. In case you're interested, I have a full video explaining the differences between MPPT and PWM charge controllers. I will say that this charge controller is for larger systems. If you're looking for something smaller or something more for the beginner side of things, you might want to have a look at the 30 or 40 amp charge controllers. Also, LiTime do offer a 30 amp charge controller if you're looking for something on a budget or on like a 400 to 500 watt solar panel array. So this 60 amp charge controller, the way I had it hooked up, I have a 800 watt solar panel array. This 60 amp MPPT charge controller can handle up to 900 to 1800 watts depending on whether you go for 12 volt or 24 volt system. And you can even get more wattage if you go for the higher voltage systems, obviously. Let's jump into the special features about what I like about this 60 amp MPPT charge controller. First off, the really cool thing is that it can handle up to 60 amps if you're charging some 100 amp hour 12 volt batteries. If you have enough solar panels connected to the charge controller, you can get upwards of 870 to a maximum of 900 watts coming in. My 12 volt system is basically two 100 amp hour batteries put in parallel, and then I'm running that into my inverter, and I have a 2000 watt inverter which runs on a 12 volt system, so I need to have two 100 amp hour batteries minimum in order to pull the maximum 186 amps or so. If I'm going to draw 2000 watts or more, you need to have two 100 amp hour batteries or two 100 amp BMSs that can handle that. If you can't afford it, try and go for the 24 volt system. It's definitely more efficient. It uses less amperage, and you can even charge possibly faster with the 60 amp MPPT charge controller because you can bring in more voltage. A nice thing with this MPPT charge controller is you've got different voltages. So you can run 12 volt, 24 volt, 36 volt, and 48 volt systems. I also like the fanless design. So it's got a really large heat sink on the back. Another thing is within the box, you get connectors and mount, so you can mount this onto your wall. And also within the box, we get a low temperature cutoff wire. So essentially what this is that you connect up this cable to the MPPT charge controller. You then put the sensor, preferably if you've got two batteries, you should try and nestle the temperature sensor in between the two. Your MPPT charge controller can serve as a low temperature cutoff, which is really useful for charging lithium ion batteries. If you don't know much about that, you can have a look at my self-heating battery video, which explains a little bit more detail about that. Another great thing with this MPPT charge controller is it's got loads of different protections. So we'll just list off some of them. We've got reverse polarity protection. So basically that means if you put the negative and the positive the wrong way round into the terminals, the system should protect itself. It also has an overvoltage protection, has an overtemperature protection. It also has a short circuit protection. It's also got an overpower protection, so it's got plenty of different protections built into the charge controller. Another great feature that I really like on this solar charge controller, which will allow us to have a look at how much amperage I was getting on my test, is the Bluetooth feature. The Bluetooth is really simple. You basically just open up the app on your phone. I think LiTime have done a good job on designing this app. In the future, a dark mode, that would be kind of cool for the app, so you could just use a black kind of dark theme. And this allows us to see the PV input. It allows us to see how much amperage is coming in, how much wattage is coming in. You can change the different chemistries, and you don't have to use the app to change some of these settings. You can actually use the buttons and the screen if you would like to. I really like the fact that they integrated the installation guide onto the template for installation. So definitely the installation was quite easy. So my maximum VOC on my panels individually is 33.6 volts. So when I put all four of them in series, not in parallel, I should see an absolute maximum of 134 volts. For every 1 degree of Celsius, as the temperature will get colder and colder, my voltage is going to go up. So you might get an absolute maximum of maybe up to 140 volts absolute maximum. This is definitely within the limits of this charge controller. I love the fact that it goes up to 150 volts. That's plenty for my needs. If you live in a very cloudy area, you might prefer having it in parallel, and that will work just fine. However, series, you will get the absolute maximum power out of it, especially when you're using this MPPT charge controller. Another little feature which I really like is it does come with a 3-year warranty. That is really neat to see that. And also, whenever you want to run DC lows, there is a terminal for that. So if you want to run lights, like a pump or anything like that, you can use the DC load. You can pick up a discount if you'd like with my discount code, the One Good Road, which can save you anywhere between 5 to 10%. So you definitely want to have a look at that. And you might want to have a look at their like new section, where you can definitely get a really good deal, sometimes 40% off or 50% off the original retail price. Now, in terms of the amperage test, I personally was able to get a maximum amperage coming into my batteries from my solar panels. I was able to get 54.8 amps coming in, which was definitely much more than my 40 amp charge controller, which was quite mind-blowing for me. I was definitely very happy with that number. So that meant that I was getting 744 watts coming in. And then what I did was I put a bunch of water over my panels, and then suddenly I was getting an extra 140 to 100 watts extra. So it was going from 600 to 700 to a 740 maximum. So that is a big difference. And that was really making me think, if I lived on an area where I had a river, definitely consider running some water over your panels if you're running them in series. It'll keep them cooler, keeps the voltage lower, and then you're able to get better performance in the summertime at least. When I did this test, I basically set a timer and I let the timer run for about 15 minutes. It was consistently holding over 50 amps coming in. The cables were warm to touch when I was testing them, but they were not hot at all. So they handled the amperage really, really well. You definitely want to think about having a fuse set up between the battery and the charge controller. And also you want to get the right proper wire gauge. And for me, I decided to use the 6 American wire gauge cable for my batteries. So that is the cable going from my charge controller to the batteries. Now, for my setup of the PV panels and the solar array that I've got, I just opted to use a collection of some 12 American wire gauge, if I'm not mistaken. Also the 10 American wire gauge. And the reason why I can get away with using much more thinner cables is because when you put all of those panels together in series, they act kind of like they're one panel. So the amperage going through the cable is very low. So there's only two things that come to mind that I thought would be worth mentioning about this charge controller that you might want to consider. One is that the lights are actually quite bright, which is a very minor thing to mention. It's really not that big of a deal. And then the only other thing that I thought was worth mentioning is the size. So a lot of people might not realize it just via the photo, but these 60 amp MPPT charge controllers are actually quite large in their footprint. But that being said, it's not overly large. It's definitely more compact than the other 60 amp MPPT charge controllers I've seen. For my next video, you might want to have a look at my battery reviews. I've done many different battery reviews on LiTime and different branded batteries, so you might want to have a look at that. Again, I have a beginner's guide getting into DIY solar. If you'd like to know what the differences are between MPPT and PWM charge controllers, you might want to have a look at my video where I did a comparison between both of these different types of charge controllers.